guys, it's the Mayhem Minute. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitters at Mayhem Show for the show. And today I wanted to talk about a little bit of, you know, I like the idea of, you know, when we're watching wrestling, when we're into indie wrestling, we have our guys, right? The guys that you saw locally. I hope a lot of you get a chance to experience this wherever you might be, whatever your local indie promotion is. And you've seen them over the years and you see them grow. And then eventually, if you're lucky enough, if they're lucky enough, you get to see them on television, hopefully on Monday Night Raw. And, you know, we've seen a little bit of that with Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins. If you're a Ring of Honor or wherever they ended up, if you're an AIW fan from or CZW, you know, these guys are familiar faces, if not names, apparently, or CM Punk's or whoever else, right? But last night, I think we had a little bit of that, too, for us here locally in Pittsburgh. Of course, with the International Wrestling Cartel, full disclosure, I do production for them now, but definitely started out as a fan watching a lot of these guys. Last night, we had the debut of Solomon Crowe, for instance, formerly Sami Calihan, of IWC, of all over the place. Wasn't Lucha Corps one of the things I think he ran? And that was really cool. And also, also last night we saw another appearance by Blue Pants, who actually, our friend from the Indie Mayhem show, Eamon, who commentates down there for Inspire Pro, just had her on the show this past weekend. You know, Leva Bates is who you would know her as. And yes, that is Kitty Pryde she's dressed up as. And typically, she does a lot of cosplay, so it really kind of fits in. Even in the introductory match, it was great to have the surprise of Rhino coming out. But we also had the pleasant surprise of another, I think his third maybe appearance on television for NXT, in a match at least, of Logan Shulo, now Elias Samson. And, you know, again, you know, And the revelation came last night that, you know, and you may have seen the tweets from Sorgatron Media or IWC or on the Facebook. It was really cool to watch an episode of NXT where their last match against each other in IWC, International Wrestling Cartel, not that other IWC, were together. Like, their last match against each other by chance at a winner takes all, and I think the year was 2012, was Logan Shulo versus Sami Calihan, now Elias Samson, now Solomon Crowe. Wait, did I mix up the names? I don't know. There's so many names going on here, and I'm trying to flip them. But either way, and even seeing a guy like Rhino, a guy I've had the fortune to sit down and talk with in an interview for the Finding Zach Gowen documentary, and seeing around, and actually still booked for IWC's Meadville show coming up here, Night of Superstars, that also has Ric Flair and Kevin Nash. It's a personal, you know, kind of high of mine to see, you know, these guys come through, guys that we've seen. Even looking at NXT, looking guys like the former El Generico, Sami Zayn, and Kevin Steen, now Kevin Owens, you know, say, oh, I watched all these guys on Ring of Honor, you know? I saw my first Ring of Honor show in New York City way back in 2007. I think I still have the flyer over here or the program over here from it. And that's the really cool thing. If you're not into indie wrestling, these are the kind of things you get to check out. You know, I guess I'm hitting that nexus point where I've been watching it for, 7-8 years, and seeing a lot of those guys come through and making it. And that just enhances watching wrestling so much to know that you saw them when there was the bingo halls in the gymnasiums, and you got to, you know, shake their hand or watch them chop your good friend from a podcast, you know, or one of them did their impression of Batista in your basement, and now he's on TNA, you know. I mean, that's the kind of cool stuff I think is happening with wrestling if you're out there and getting access to these kinds of stuff on the independent level. So I guess the story of the day: one, watch NXT. It's amazing right now. If you don't like WWE's product, there's hope somewhere, and you got to pay $9.99 for it, or go check it out on Hulu. I think it might be free to watch on Hulu right now. I'll have to check that. They've been going back and forth with that. So you can actually get it for $7.99 without the specials. But and also, please, just look up your independent pro wrestling. We've been trying to post I'll probably post the latest one again here today since I'm bringing this topic up. Nate Stein does a wonderful email press newsletter that goes around that lists every independent wrestling promotion I think is out there. And we've been poking at that on the Indie Mayhem Show. And check out the Indie Mayhem Show. We've been talking to some great people, including Jessica James, Colin Delaney, DJ Z from TNA, as I sort of mentioned before, Baby Batista. Check out everything else, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Follow us, subscribe on YouTube, and we'll see you guys next time. Let us know what you think of the indie wrestlers making it on our TV set. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at SorgatronMedia.com.